Hey guys, we're back. It's still January.
Again.
5 weeks. But forever. We're so happy to have you again. We are Brian and Carol Smith, and we are large group leaders in the family ministry program at Cobb Prairie Community Church in Lenexa, Kansas. And again, thanks for joining us today. We're happy there's 5 weeks in January, so we could spend some extra time with you guys. So this is our last week, though, in our series called Subscribe Now.
Subscribe Now.
And we have been having fun learning about what it means to subscribe, or all the ways we can follow Jesus, okay? And we are excited to share that with you today, but first, let's sing and dance.
Let's. Received an instant message from a friend, maybe on a phone or an app that you might have.
Do you remember your AOL screen name?
No.
I don't either.
It's a long time ago.
Yeah.
So long. Something cool, I'm sure. Or maybe it was a game you were playing, back to the subject at hand, a game you were playing, and maybe somebody's, you know, typing messages to you. And I personally get super happy when I get a text from a friend, when my phone or my watch says, ding, it means somebody wants to talk to me.
You actually get texts from people?
I do. Not from you. Now he will. So lots of people share selfies and GIFs and stickers and Bitmojis and other fun things through their instant messaging technology. So that's funny you said that, Mr. Brian, because I have a question for you.
Okay.
What was the last text message or instant message that a friend or family member sent you?
I'm pretty sure you asked me about camping on a sand dune.
Isn't that so fun? I know. So it was me. Yeah. What about you guys? Can you think of the last message that you received, or picture or sticker that you received from someone? To think. Mine might have been my mom. Mm-hmm. So today's Bible story tells us that Jesus was not like other teachers or prophets. Jesus's message was powerful And people were amazed when they heard it and started to follow him. If Jesus was on earth right now, people would probably say Jesus was trending. Pretty cool, huh? Let's hashtag. Watch. Hashtag trending. We're going to watch now and listen to the story.
Jesus and his companions went to the town of Capernaum. When the Sabbath day came, he went into the synagogue and began to teach. The people were amazed at his teaching, for he taught with real authority, quite unlike the teachers of religious law. Suddenly, a man in the synagogue who was possessed by an evil spirit cried out, "Why are you interfering with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." But Jesus reprimanded him, "Be quiet. Come out of the man," he ordered. At that, the evil spirit screamed, threw the man into a convulsion, and then came out of him. Amazement gripped the audience, and they began to discuss what had happened. "What sort of new teaching is this?" they asked excitedly. "It has such authority. Even evil spirits obey his orders." The news about Jesus spread quickly throughout the entire region of Galilee.
Wow, that is a crazy story, Mr. Brian.
Crazy.
Wow, thank you to everyone who has sent in your pictures and illustrations this month because they have been super cool. Okay. All right, so as you can imagine, people were probably amazed and shocked at what they had just seen and heard. They could not believe that Jesus had the power to do that. And after that, the news of Jesus's power spread even quicker. I bet it was like trending. See how that works. But before we get to our big idea, which might have something to do with the story, let's watch Carl and Andy. How about that? Let's see what they have to say.
Hey everybody, hey, it's Andy.
Are you gonna say your name?
What are you doing?
What are
you Subscribe. Welcome to. Make sure to like and subscribe. Welcome to GrowTV.
Welcome to GrowTV. Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends. Talk about Jesus and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to GrowTV.
So, why are you repeating me? Why are you doing this?
This isn't fun.
Is this like a social experiment? What is going on right now? I don't like this. Are you mad at me? Are you frustrated? If you're trying to prove a point, I don't know what it is. Would you please stop? Are you mad at me? Are you mad at me? At your chicken nuggets?
You did what?
I ate your chicken nuggets.
You did what?
Yep.
No! You didn't eat my chicken nuggets.
No, I didn't.
Why would you say that?
I just didn't like what you were doing. You were repeating after me. I didn't like that. I figured if I did that, it would make you stop repeating
me. No, I'm just kidding. What's up?
Nothing. I guess I was just wondering why you were doing that.
Oh, you know. I was just doing a little experiment.
Experiment? For what?
You see, I was reading this week's Bible story, and Jesus reacted a certain way when a man interrupted him. And I wanted to see what you would do.
Oh, got it. Where was the story?
Mark 1, verses 21 through 28.
Oh, yeah, I remember this story. It's when Jesus went to the synagogue and he was on the Sabbath.
Yep, Jesus was telling everyone about God.
Yeah, and I remember everyone was super amazed and super impressed because the message that Jesus was giving was something new that no one had ever heard before.
What was different about it?
Well, everyone before Jesus taught the scriptures like they learned it from someone else.
Got it. So like most teachers.
But Jesus, he taught with authority. Like he didn't just know about the scripture. He knew exactly what they meant. He understood God's word and explained it better than anyone has ever seen.
Well, I bet that was real different for most of the people.
It sure was. People hadn't had a teacher like Jesus, so this was all new for them.
Well, yeah, it's because Jesus wasn't any old teacher. He was the Messiah, the Savior of the world.
Exactly. So anyway, Jesus was sitting there in the synagogue. He was teaching, and out of nowhere...
Ah!
What was that?
It was a loud cry. That's what happened. In the story, the man cried out while Jesus was teaching.
Oh, right. Well, the thing is, this man wasn't trying to be rude or anything. A bad spirit had taken over this man, and it asked what Jesus wanted. And get this, it knew who Jesus was.
That's crazy.
Sure was. So you know what Jesus said?
Be quiet!
Sorry?
Be quiet.
Oh, you're talking about the story?
Yeah.
Okay, got it. Then Jesus told the spirit to come out of the man. And you remember what happened next?
The spirit came out. And everybody watching was so impressed.
Why do you think they were so impressed?
Well, think about it. That spirit was super powerful. No one there, and the guy himself couldn't get rid of it. But Jesus did it like that!
And on top of that, Jesus was teaching with authority.
Exactly! That had to have opened the eyes of so many people that were there!
In what ways do you think? Kind of like, eyes open like...
No, Andy! Oh. Pay attention to the story!
Sorry.
Psalm 111 tells us God is so powerful. Gracious, loving, and trustworthy. I'm sure the people back then knew this scripture too. And then the Son of God, Jesus, shows up and starts teaching and healing people. By doing that, Jesus shows that what the Bible says about God is true. I don't know about you, but I think that is pretty cool.
You're right, Carl. I think we should always remember that.
How could I forget?
Well, it sounds like something easy to remember, but we forget things all the time.
I guess that's true.
I guess my point is that we have so many messages in this world that are coming from so many different places. Our phones, our TVs, the shows we watch, our friends, our family. It could just be hard to understand which message to listen to.
You're telling me, I get all these messages from people who are subscribing to my YouTube channel, and it's hard to listen to all of them.
Totally, but maybe the only message we actually should listen to is the one with authority.
Who would that be?
You want to guess?
Is it Jesus?
It's Jesus.
I knew it! Yes!
You see, the message that Jesus shared about God is the only message that actually will last and truly change our lives.
Wow, always last and change our lives. That's powerful.
That's right, Carl. The message of Jesus is powerful.
You know what else is powerful?
What? Okay, what's going on?
Oh, Andy.
What?
You're new to this.
I am. I don't know what's...
And I'm about to tell you what else is powerful.
Okay. I'm ready. I'm ready for it.
You just saw a big idea! Today's big idea is the message of Jesus is powerful.
So let's say it out loud on the count of three. One,
two, three.
The message of Jesus is powerful! Yes!
Good job! Wow, I learned a lot today.
So did I. Also learned something I didn't expect to.
What is that?
I know how to annoy you now.
How? Okay, yeah, not this again. You have to stop. This isn't fun. How old are you? This is you're a host of a TV show, and you're repeating me like a child. Are you repeating my size now? Have a good week, kids. See you next time.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of RoTV.
Thanks, Carl and Andy. So, when was the first time you guys heard about Jesus? Who told you? Who told the person who told you? Imagine the number of people the message of Jesus had been told to just to get to you. Think about that. People from today's story didn't have the internet. Social media, they didn't have phones. They probably didn't even have a working mail system, let's be honest. They had to generally tell people.
They put it in like a little bird beak and fly it?
Only in the movies.
Okay. Yeah. I was thinking that'd be really cool.
So, how did the message of Jesus spread then?
Not a bird beak, apparently. Basket in the little mouth. Okay, so the Bible is the most copied and read and most frequently referenced book in the world. A fun fact. Ready? Did you know that even if all the Bibles in the world were to disappear, which would be awful, we would still be able to piece it back together completely through all the other books that aren't the Bible? Crazy, isn't it?
Crazy.
But the message didn't spread all by itself. The pages in the Bible didn't fly around the world on their own or with the help of a bird. Someone had to tell someone and then pass it on. And then the next person did the same thing, and it took a lot of people's hard work and even sometimes suffering to make sure that the message of Jesus was heard and can still be heard everywhere.
The message of Jesus is so powerful to change people's lives when they hear it. Think about that. The message of Jesus is so powerful that when they hear it, it changes their lives. That's
huge impact.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
But it's our job, here's the kicker, it's our job to make sure people hear it. Yeah. Okay? Just 5 weeks.
It's that time again.
It was fun.
It's been good.
Yeah. But thanks again, guys, for joining us. It has been awesome. We've had a lot of fun with you guys this month. And as always, we want you to stay connected with us. Okay? So check out the KP website for additional information. There's activities you guys can do with your family. And there's more content for you guys. And most importantly, you can stay connected with Miss Kim and the ministry. But sadly, it is time for us to say goodbye today and to this month. So we will be back in the future. And you guys will see some new people next week.
Yeah.
But we hope you come back and we enjoyed our time with y'all. Okay?
Been real.
But before we go, Miss Carol is going to pray for us.
All right. Join me in prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us a powerful message. We are glad that it has reached us thousands of years later, miles and miles from where it started. Help me to be a part of carrying your message to others so that more people will hear and be changed by your message of love and hope. Amen.
Amen.
All right, I hope you guys have a super great week. I hope you learn something from all of this that we've been talking and teaching about, and we can't wait to see you again.
Have an awesome February, guys. Bye.